said there's nothing is certain in life except death and taxes. That sound deep, don't it? It ain't deep, y'all. Because a slick person, Slick Rick, that get him a good lawyer, he can find a way around his taxes. He ain't even got to be Rick. He could be Donald Trump. I don't know why y'all looking at me like that. He still ain't gave us the tax returns. Come on, say amen, somebody. Some people, they can get around taxes, but no one escapes death. Come on, say amen, somebody. Everybody, I mean, that's so profound. Two things you're going to do in life. You're going to pay taxes and you're going to die. No, you might not pay taxes, but you're going to die. And death is a grief-producing process, but it simply serves to remind us that this place is not our home, and this is just a temporary rest stop on the way to our eternal home. We are only separated in time, but there will come a time when the wicked shall cease from troubling and the weary shall not be at rest. And I thank God. We only got 3 more minutes. Y'all think I'm saved. I thank God for Paul, because Paul does something I love. He paves our perceptive path with proper perspective. He paves our perceptive path with proper perspective. If you forgot that, just say, I know it got a lot of P's in it. Whatever he said, it has a whole lot of P's. Come on, say amen, somebody. Because what it does is that it gets us to embrace the internal, the external, as opposed to being traumatized by the temporal. We want to embrace the eternal and not be traumatized by the temporal. So let me give y'all a few scriptures before I get up out of here. 2 Corinthians 5:1. Paul says, for we know if our earthly house or this tabernacle was desired, he said, we have a building, my God. A building of God is not made by hands that is eternal in the heavens. As a child of God, it says, for we know. Now, that ain't entitlement for everybody. Those are folk who got their business straightened up. Those are folk who have their reservation for their eternal destination. Those are those folk who have a relationship with God that this ain't it. And Paul says, for we know, you need to ask yourself, am I a we? Am I a we? That's not general inclusion. Those are invitational approved inclusions. Come on, say amen, somebody. Invitational inclusions. For we know. Not that we guess. When we see the word know, it means faith. We talking about the word genosko. I ain't gonna got time to teach that, but when we know, we ain't got the body. He said, but we know if this earth tabernacle, this body, if it be desired, I ain't got to worry about it. Because right here, sometimes those legs hurt and sometimes those feet hurt. I gotta get a hip replacement and a leg replacement and an elbow replacement. He said, we got a house that's not made by man's hands. So I ain't got to get a new knee up there. Come on, say amen, somebody. I ain't got to get nothing replaced up there because when I get up there, I've got something eternal. Somebody say eternal. Then 2 Corinthians 5:8, he says to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. I hate to tell you, I hate to bust your bubble, baby. But some of you right now, you be saying, I just want to go see mama one more time. I just want to go see grandmama one more time. But listen, it said to be absent from the body, mean present with the Lord. So they've been with the Lord all this time. And you like, I just want mama to come back one more time. I want grandma come. I'm telling you, like I told you last week, you would go up there and mama be up there in the kitchen and knock on the door. Hello, it's not your time yet. I just want my mama to come down here. I just want my grandma to come here one more time. Grandma! She over there flying through that. And you say, I want you to come back. You talk like fool. You lost your mind. Woo-hoo. Come on, say amen, somebody. Play it tag with the angel. You hit. I can fly and catch you. Once you've been in the presence of God and you ain't got no Ameren, you ain't got no water bill, you ain't got no light bill, you ain't got to pay for your kids' books, you ain't got to pay for uniforms. Come on, say amen, somebody. They playing sports, making your school popular, but you got to pay for their uniform. Come on, say amen, somebody. You ain't got to pay nothing. And you think I'm going to step back in here with all this debt? Some of us didn't get out of debt till we died. Y'all ain't going to help me. Because there ain't nothing they can do about it now. Come on, say amen, somebody. So absent from the body means to be present with the Lord. So I leave you to this until we talk some more. There's a bad news, good news found in 1 Corinthians 15 and 22. I call it the bad news, the good news scripture. It says, for as in Adam, and we all come from Adam, we all must die. But in Christ, we shall be made alive. So tell somebody, that's the negative. But I thank God that it ends with the positive. For in Adam, we got to die. But in Christ, we shall be made alive. I love the way my grandmama used to say it. Grandmama used to sing something that they call a Dr. Watts. And I didn't understand it. I didn't understand it till I got old enough to learn what death really meant. Grandmama used to say, I died one time. Ain't gonna die no more. And I used to wonder, Steve, what was she talking about? She talking about I died one time and I ain't gotta die no more. But what grandmama was saying, I died, got to die one time, but I don't have to die a second time, because when I die one time, I've got a situation that I've hooked up with Jesus who died for me. Anybody know about Jesus? He died one Friday, but only one Sunday he got up with all power in his hands. Tell somebody, I died one time, I ain't gonna die no more. Give God some praise. Come on, say amen, somebody. Amen. Did that help anybody? Did that help you understand death? And if you do that, then you can say you feel like going on. I feel like going on, because I understand death. I feel like going on, though trials come on every hand, I feel like going home. Now that I understand death, I can say that I feel like going on. Do I have a witness to say that I feel like going on, though trials come on every hand, I feel like going on. Now that I know that I got another place I can say, I feel like preaching on. Now that I know that that ain't it, but they put in the casket. I feel like, Mom, I feel like preaching on. Though trials come on every hand, I feel like preaching on. The doors of church open. We extend an invitation to life. I got to go, but I said, I feel like singing on. On. I feel like singing on. Though trials come on every hand. feel like singing on. Is that one? I feel like going on. Talk about I feel
like going.
I wish I had one witness. I tell somebody I feel. Some praise.